Hello guys, and welcome to war number 11 of the season. We are almost at the finish line, and we really need a win to place in Masters. So we fight here Stella, the Chinese alliance. So I'm starting on path 9 here, and I'm bringing Corvus with Proxima Synergy and Void. So we have a Mordo here. I boosted a bit, and I will pop a invulnerability boost because I was afraid I might push him to the special 3. Sorry, I still have that cold. So here, the idea is to trigger Astral Evade. He didn't punish, and now try and get a heavy here after when he gets to his power gain. Now I can use my heavy, so I get a true strike. And now I can parry and use another heavy. But I didn't do that. I waited again for him to go to the power gain. And now he was really cooperative with the special ones. Now I'm going for some dash back intercepts. And yeah, I got 2 strikes, so this fight will go pretty easy for now. Special 2, and he's down. So now I have 2 strike, really easy fight. Got a 2 strike. Now I'm going to this Thor Ragnarok on the intercept Aegis node. And I need to do 3 intercepts, and now that I have 2 strike, I can get auto blocks, so this shouldn't be so hard. And I can get my second charge free because Thor Ragnarok is an Avenger. So I see 1 intercept, 2 intercepts didn't work there. I got to health block fast here. He doesn't want to cooperate, he used a special 1. 1 more dash back here, and yeah, got the mission done. The invulnerability down. So here I'm using my special 2 to stop his power gain. He used the special 2, and the fight is pretty much done with a combo here. So I got the second charge, and this fight was really easy. Next on, I'm on path 3 in the section 2, the auto block and evade path, and the biohazard. So I'm bringing Corvus for this fight. You see that I have the 2 charges, and I don't care about auto block from Modok here. So this fight will go pretty well, and if I get the bleed, it doesn't do damage to Corvus, so that helps because it's healing me. But when he uses the special 1, it reverses that heal, so I'm taking a bit of damage. The second special 1 here. Now I just have to wait and build my combo, use a special 2, and yeah, Modok down, really easy and fast. Next fight, we have here a stealth suit Spidey. Nothing too difficult with Corvus and True Strike, just trying to build the special 2 and kill him really fast. And he has low health. We are facing Dutch Global, but that doesn't affect us because of the True Strike on Corvus. So here, normal combos. Now backup recovering to be careful. He's pushed to the special 2, but I'm thinking, yeah, 1 more combo. And then holding block here. I did a hit in the air by mistake, and that triggers makes him come at you because of the before updated Nightcrawler trick. But yeah, didn't need him to use any special, just got hit out really fast. So yeah, going to the next fight, we have here the Domino on the buffer node, and this is what I brought Void for. And I took off Suicide, so this is the first time I'm taking Suicide this war, and I'll be taking them again for the boss fight. But yeah, here with the Void, I didn't use an advanced power boost because I need 1 for the boss, and I think I only have 2, so I'm holding 1 for the last part of the season because I knew that this fight I would be I won't really need it. It helps to have the power boost, but you see that in the end it is better not using it because I got fast the 2 petrifies and 1 debuff, so now I can really place another buff. So I was really lucky with placing the buffs here. She didn't crit failed none of them, and now I can reverse the damage from buffet, and you see me doing that a lot here, evading again, doing her buffet damage. So the fight is going pretty fast, as you see. Usually this fight it's long and you need to be careful to fear the Void. Here I triggered the dexterity again, but didn't get it because of crit fail. But yeah, she's almost dead. Now one hit and Buffett kills her. Really fast and easy with Void here. Now I'm putting Suicides back on and taking this Dusa fight. So these were the, when I started playing at this domino, these were the last six fights of the war, and I needed to not die more than two times because we would have lost it. That happens. So a bit of pressure here, but after the fiasco of the last war that I died three times, and even it, though it didn't come because it was lost, I was really upset about that. I wanted to come here strong and clear all without dying. So let's see how this works. So domino down. Now we have a Medusa here on the debuff immune and power special lock one, but you see that Corvus has no problem with this fight. Even though I can't use my special two, those two charges are enough, and I'm boosted pretty big because I'm going in one go through the boss and all. So yeah, Corvus really good for this fight. Now gonna go on the mini boss on the counter tactics, and we have a sentinel here. So again, really nice fight for Corvus, and I can get my first charge. I'm going to take this the other two mini bosses. So here on this sentinel, we baiting the heavies here because it's stun immune. So baiting the heavy, going for normal combos because we don't care about building analysis charges. Knight intercept there. Here baiting the special two, evade. I didn't want to bait the special 2, just wanted to do one more combo, but he used it really fast, and yeah, special 2 and sentinel, it's down. Next fight, on the strike back and recovery mini boss, we have here a blade, so I'm bringing Corvus with 3 charges, and I need to pay attention because I have bleed on me because of suicide, so he will have an increase in power gain, but yeah. Yeah, I need to be careful to not try and parry after a special, after he gets one part of power. Nothing really difficult here. You see that his regen is really big, but I don't care about that because he won't be regening any much. I'm betting here the special one again. Come on, use the special one. Okay, now I don't have bliss, so I don't have to worry about him getting power gain. One more combo here, and I'll be using my special 2. But I wait to bait the special 1 again just because it's strike back, but he doesn't want to use it. He finally used it. One more parry here, and the special 2 after the combo will finish the fight. So yeah, Corvus again really good for this fight. And for the last mini boss, we have a champion here on the debuff immune mini boss, and I wasn't sure how this fight will go. I didn't want to pop an advanced power boost because I knew that I have to redo my mastery, that I don't have enough time to go in after that in the thing fight, and to have to change some boosts, and you'll see what boost. So here I'm going fast and trying to beat the special to as fast as I can because I don't want him to get in the second primal fury to have the unstoppable and to have to dance around that. And here almost got to the special 2, but he's pushed into power here. He used the special 2, and now I will use my special 2 and intercept. He's almost dead. I get to the special 2 again for the cosmic boost, even though I need the cosmic boost because I needed just one more hit. So yeah, pretty clear and nice fight still now. And for the last fight of this war, you see that I switch again. I took off the suicides. I replaced the cosmic boost with science boost. So a lot of boosts used for this war, but I really wanted to get the win here for our team. So here is not a huge pressure to get a solo. Even if I die or timeout, I can finish the fight, and this will work pretty well. And yeah. So Void versus Thing fight, nothing new for me, using the special one here, and yeah, trying to take this fight really careful. Now I use the tip with the rock stacks. Now he's at 13-14. I don't know why I didn't get there to the special in time, probably because I don't know, didn't get enough power there. But anyway, here I get an I trigger the first time the heavy there, the protection, sorry, and now I have two petrifies and two other debuffs. I'm reversing that willpower, doing a normal combo here, but use the special after three hits to get him at 15 rock stacks, and now baiting the special two here. The fight is going pretty well. I have Fear of the Void up, here's the special one here, which is not a problem because it's a lot till he gets to the 15 rock stacks. Here I use the special and now I'm holding block to bait the heavy here, medium, light, medium for the power increase. So yeah, the fight is going pretty well. Here I have Fear of the Void and 3 debuffs. So now I'm building to the special 2 here. One more combo here to get him at 15 rock stacks and to use the special 2. He's really cooperating. Now I can pop my special 2 here on the Fear of the Void, even though I trigger protection, but these debuffs will do a lot of damage here, pushing him block and trying to push him to 15 before he uses the special here. Nice, push him into the block to the 15, use the special 2, so the fight is going pretty well. And now that I have those two weaknesses from the special 2, I can pop a lot more special 1 to get more debuffs and to drain his health really fast. So yeah, 15 again. I was really managing well the rock stacks. I really like Void for Fing fights. I'm really confident in these fights all of the time. Even though last season I died a few times, this season I was really good on this Fing boss. And yeah, now I have to Fear the Voids up, so the hits will trigger protection, but I have a lot of time. He's in assassin range. He used the special 2 here. Now I have only one Fear the Void combo, is the special 1. Really confident in this fight, it's a solo. I need him to intercept there, nice. So yeah, kill the debuff. So really happy how this war went. I think I took 11 fights and I didn't die at once. So really happy with this war and we won this one. So we are really close to finishing in Master and we'll see how the last war goes. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.